Hey, what's going on out there? I'm Sean Devine. Hope you all are doing well. Today's video, we're going to be breaking down my external hard drive setup, as well as some tips for you guys to maximize efficiency and performance in the DAW with your sessions, with your plugins. Also going to talk about some storage and backup tips, which we don't talk about enough, but it's incredibly important to create this redundancy in your studio environment. I'm going to show you the cloud storage service that I've been utilizing for a long time that creates more redundancy beyond just these physical drives. I'm also going to give you guys some buyer's tips in terms of what I would recommend for external hard drives. So let's go ahead and dive in. All right, so let's talk about my external hard drive setup. I've been utilizing this same setup for a very long time. The only thing that's changed is I just recently switched to all solid state drives. We'll talk about why I made that switch here in a little bit, but let's just talk about the three specific drives that I have here. These are all the same model, which is a G drive mobile SSD. This is not a sponsored video. I'm just gonna tell you what's worked for me. G drives have been very reliable and consistent for me. I still have spinning physical drives that I use for, you know, extra session backups that are still running that I bought, you know, 7 or 8 years ago. I have two terabyte mobile SSDs. These are USB 3.1. And one is a content drive, or what I call my working drive, which is what's going to be loading all the session files, all the audio files, all of the audio and sound content for, you know, various instruments. Everything except for the software itself is going to be stored here. Then I have a duplicate. It's the same model of this drive, 2 terabyte. And this is just a backup of my content or my working drive. It's always good to have a duplicate or a clone of all of your content. If this ever goes down, then I know it's all here, and I back this up daily to keep it consistent. And I am very conscientious about how I organize the file structure, the folders, the naming. But what that also allows me to do is it makes it easy to, at the end of the day, just make sure and create consistency by dragging over, you know, sessions I worked on that day, or, you know, maybe I added some new sounds to a library. It's easy just to drag and drop. Now, there are some automated solutions for cloning drives. I've tried them in the past with decent results. It's up to you. I personally find it, you know, very easy to just spend a couple of minutes at the end of the workday and just drag over whatever folders that I have been working on. Now, the third drive is a 1 terabyte. Again, same model as these 2 terabytes, but just half the size. And I utilize this for Time Machine, specifically in OS X. So those of you who are Mac users, Time Machine is a great utility that will back up the entire hard drive in your computer, all the system files, all the OS files, all your plugins, your software. It will basically create a working copy on a hard drive. So if anything ever happened to your internal drive, which that has happened to me, I have had internal drives on my laptops and my computers die. And when they do, this Time Machine backup becomes absolutely indispensable. It's very easy to back up an entire machine to the exact working specs. So obviously, you know, having redundant physical drives is great, but you also want to have something that's offsite, or quote, in the cloud. So I utilize a cloud service called Crash Plan for small business, and this is by a company called Code42. Once again, not a sponsored video. I've just been utilizing this service with good results for a while, but this has some cool features about it. You know, number one, you can be very specific about the drives as well as the specific folders and files that you want to back up. So for me, what I do is I back up from my 2 terabyte backup drive, right? So that leaves the working drive free to do whatever it is I'm working on, no matter when this backup to the cloud is running. That 2 terabyte backup drive is there to provide the backup to the cloud. I also back up some files and folders from the internal on my laptop. The other cool thing about Crash Plan is that you can set up a schedule. And so I have it set up to run every day of the week. and it will start a backup at 11 and run to 7 a.m., however long it needs to go to create a full backup. If I'm still working during those hours, it will pause, and then I can just start it whenever I'm finished, and it will continue to, you know, utilize those hours to do backups. At the beginning of each backup, it will, you know, calculate what has changed on your drive automatically. You don't have to, you know, reselect any files. It automatically makes sure that all that stuff is consistent in between backups. So as far as my recommendations for those of you in the market for external drives, obviously I would recommend solid state drives. They are more expensive than the physical spinning drives, but they're a lot faster. They have better performance. And for me, a really important thing about those is that they're silent. So before I had these, I had, again, the same setup, but with physical spinning drives. And these are the bigger G drives that have fans, and they're really loud. So those of you who ask why I utilize a noise gate on my vocals for so many years, a big reason is because of those loud drives. If you can't afford solid state drives, it's okay. You can still utilize these physical spinning drives. This is a 1 terabyte mobile USB G drive, USB 3.0. This is gonna be a lot more cost efficient, and you can still get good results with it. Important thing to note before you start buying hard drives is to make sure and take into account what type of connections you have on your laptop or on a hub that you might be utilizing in your system. So for me, I have Thunderbolt 3, thankfully, on my laptop. Very fast connection, and I can connect these drives via USB 3.1, either through those on the laptop or on my hub. Now, I want to just point out that on the hub, I have noticed that I get different speeds depending on which port I plug it into. So the specs on that hub vary depending on where you plug this in. And if you all are using, you know, low quality, unpowered hubs, you're going to find that the speed that you're getting, even on really fast drives like these SSDs, is not going to be where it could be. Something I would recommend for you all to do to check the performance of the connection you have for your hard drive is to try out a utility like Blackmagic Speed Test, and this will allow you to measure the read and write speeds for your drive. So just experimenting and figuring out which of those connections was the fastest actually doubled my read and write speeds on my working drive. So highly recommend doing that and figuring out what's the best for your setup. You know, as far as size, again, having two 2 terabyte working drives for me is plenty. You know, I have a lot of sessions, a lot of different sound and audio files for the different instruments I use. So for most of you out there, that's going to be way more than enough. And then just having the 1 terabyte for the Time Machine is plenty, because I'm keeping all that content off of the internal. So what's actually on my laptop hard drive is not that much. It's pretty minimal. And one, you know, full Time Machine backup is about 250 to 300 gigs. All right, y'all. So that is my external hard drive setup for storage as well as backup, in addition to the cloud service. I know that many of you might have different preferences than me, but I hope this gives you an idea of how you can implement these into your workflow to give you the best efficiency, the best performance, and also peace of mind to have that redundancy in all of these files that you work so hard for in the studio. If you have any questions or comments about external hard drives, as well as the cloud service we covered, feel free to leave a comment below. If you learned anything in the video, please like, subscribe, and consider sharing. We'll talk to you soon.